This video explains how to use ARMA models for forecasting. We also introduce the concept of unconditional and conditional forecasts. To simplify the exposition and to get the main learning points across, we will focus in this video on an AR1 model for a demeaned time series XT. But note, at the end of this video, I also show you how to do a forecasting if XT has a mean of non-zero. Okay. Now, whatever we show here for that simple process, these techniques can be applied to any more general ARMA PQ model. So let's start. The data generating process of a stationary zero mean AR1 process is given in this next equation. So we assume XT plus 1 equals phi times XT plus the white noise process epsilon t plus 1. So the time series starts in 0 at the unconditional mean of 0. The stationarity means the absolute value of phi is below 1. And then the epsilon t has this IID process. Okay. Now, looking carefully at that model shows that XT contains predictive information about XT plus 1. To be fair, only if the phi is non-zero. All right. But in fact, the FT forecast for XT plus 1 would be exactly phi times XT. Such a forecast is called conditional forecast. To be more precise, we can say that phi times XT is the conditional one step ahead forecast for XT plus 1. Now let's verify that this is indeed the correct forecast. So conceptually, the conditional one step ahead forecast for XT plus 1 is defined as the expectation of XT plus 1 conditional on FT. Now just plug in the AR1 data generating process for XT plus 1 and you see that the conditional expectation is nothing else than the conditional expectation of phi times XT plus epsilon t plus 1 and you condition on FT. So now ask yourself, which information is part of the FT information set? Well, that is XT and the constant parameters like phi, x0 and sigma square epsilon. And finally, as variables of your information set are actually observed, the expectation coincides with that observation. So hence, just put them outside of the expectation operator. This means that you can write the expectation of phi xt plus epsilon t plus 1 conditional on ft as phi times xt plus the expectation of epsilon t plus 1 conditional on ft. And here, the assumption of epsilon t being an IID white noise process is really important. It tells us that this last expectation, so the expectation of epsilon t plus 1 conditional on ft, is indeed zero. Hence the conditional one step ahead forecast for xt plus 1 is in fact indeed phi times xt. So we summarize that in the last equation. Okay, now we've accomplished really a milestone, and yeah, that gets a big check. Now, we want to go on and ask, what is the conditional two-step-ahead forecast? So mathematically, we want to determine the expectation of xt plus 2 conditional on ft. In order to do so, we follow the same logic. First, we plug in the data generating process for xt plus 2. Second, we do recursive substitution to write xt plus 2 such that the only randomness as of ft are the white noise shocks epsilon. So let's do that. On the left hand side, we have the expectation of xt plus 2 conditional on ft. And that should be determined for X being an AR1 process. So first, rewrite XT plus 2 by its AR1 structure, which gives you the expectation of phi XT plus 1 plus epsilon t plus 2. Now, rewrite XT plus 1 by its AR1 structure. So you substitute, instead of XT plus 1, you substitute in phi XT plus epsilon t plus 1. All of that gets multiplied by the phi, and you keep adding the epsilon t plus 2. Now multiply out everything, and you end up with the expectation of phi squared times xt plus phi epsilon t plus 1 and the epsilon t plus 2, everything in the expectation. Now these are conditional expectations as of ft. So again, ask yourself what is known as of ft. And the phi is known, the xt is known, so you put out the first product of phi squared xt outside of the expectation. Then you end up with plus phi times the expectation of epsilon t plus 1 conditional on ft plus the expectation of epsilon t plus 2 conditional on ft. Now, since epsilon again is a white noise process, the conditional expectations are simply zero, so therefore we know the two-step ahead forecast for the AR1 process is simply the current value for x times phi to the power of 2. Now we can generalize that exercise to a conditional k-step ahead forecast, where k is any number larger than 0. So we've verified so far that the conditional forecast for k equals 1 is simply phi times xt. The conditional forecast for k equals 2 has been phi to the power of 2 times xt. And now, maybe not surprising, we just see in a minute that the k-step conditional forecast is simply phi to the power of k times xt. Now, so we wonder, what is the forecast if k goes to infinity? Well, let's write it down explicitly. We are looking for the conditional forecast of xt plus k conditional on ft, where k goes to infinity. And that is nothing else than phi to the power of k times xt, where k goes to infinity. Now looking at that, we see that it really matters which value phi takes. Now there are three cases that we have to consider. The absolute value of phi could be smaller than 1, it could be equal than 1, or larger than 1. Let's look at this first case. Now, if the absolute value of phi is below 1, then we see that the limit of the conditional forecast of xt plus k approaches 0. Because if you have a number below 1 and you take it to the power of k and k goes to infinity, that converges to 0. Now, case number 2 happens if the absolute value of phi is 1. In that case, the limit of the conditional forecast for an infinite horizon approaches xt itself. And in the third case, the absolute value of phi is above 1, we get an explosion, meaning the conditional long time horizon forecast for the AR1 series x just explodes, it goes to infinity. Now, let's introduce two notations. The first is about unconditional forecasts, and the other is about weak stationarity. And then we go back to these three cases to tease out additional intuition. So definition number one about the unconditional forecast. The unconditional forecast of a time series xt is denoted as the expectation of xt. We can also write that as the expectation of xt conditional on f0. And that coincides with the conditional forecast of xt plus k, where k goes to infinity. So here you have a mapping between the unconditional and the conditional forecast. Keep that in mind. It's really important. Now the second definition is about weak stationarity. A time series xt is weakly stationary if its unconditional forecast and autocovariance matrix is time invariant, meaning constant. Okay, now we go back to these three cases. And we learned that Xt, which we assume to follow a zero mean AR1 process, is only weakly stationary if the absolute value of phi is below 1. I'm going to verify in another video that this condition also implies a constant autocovariance. For case 3, we say that the dynamics of Xt are explosive, as we expect x to blow up to infinity over time. And for case 2, we see that the unconditional forecast of Xt is Xt itself, so it's time varying. And a statistician would say that Xt has a unit root. Note, if data is weakly stationary, its mean and autocovariance should be the same across subsamples. And that's the way how you can test that in the data. Okay. Now, I want you to see an additional way to get the unconditional forecast of an ARMA model. As ARMA PQ processes must be stationary, we can rely on a very convenient stationarity condition, which says that the expectation of Xt equals the expectation of Xt minus k for any k. So hence, if Xt follows an AR1 process, as in the next equation, then we can put the expectation sign on the left and on the right, and we end up with the expectation of Xt equals phi times the expectation of t minus 1. Now, as both unconditional expectations need to be the same, as we just said previously, by stationarity, the expectation of Xt and the expectation of Xt minus 1 are the same, the only solution that fulfills this equation would be if the expectation of Xt is indeed 0. Now lastly, what do I do if my data is not mean 0? Well, there are two ways to approach that issue. First, you demean the time series, then you forecast the demeaned time series into the future, and you add again the mean. Now, second, that's the approach I prefer, you account explicitly for a constant in the data generating process. Now, let's do that for the AR1 example. Now, the AR1 for x being not mean 0 means xt plus 1 equals a constant, which I call c, plus phi xt plus epsilon t plus 1. So epsilon t plus 1 is our white noise process, c is a constant, and the absolute value of phi shall be below 1. Now the conditional one step ahead forecast of that time series is simply c plus phi xt. The conditional two step ahead forecast is as follows. Again, we want the expectation of xt plus 2 conditional on ft. Now rewrite xt plus 2 by its AR1 representation. That would be the expectation of c plus phi xt plus 1 plus epsilon t plus 2. Now you have to once again substitute the AR1 structure into xt plus 1, which gives you this term in the next equation. And now again you ask yourself carefully, what is part of the information set ft? These are all constants and any variable with an index t. So therefore you can put the c outside of the operator, of the expectation operator. You can put the phi times c outside of the operator, expectation operator, and the phi square times xt. Now the conditional expectations of epsilon t plus 1 and epsilon t plus 2, they are just 0 because of the white noise process assumption. So you end up with that the conditional two-step ahead forecast of the AR1 process with a non-zero c is simply c times phi to the power of 0 plus phi to the power of 1 plus phi squared times xt. Now, we can generalize that to the conditional k step-ahead forecast, which is just summarized in the next equation. So you see that if you have a constant and non-zero mean in your time series, then the conditional AR1 forecast is not just phi to the k times the current value, but you also have to carry with you the constant c, which gets multiplied by the sum of the phi to the power of I. Now, from that expression, we could also get the unconditional forecast by taking the limit of the previous expression, and doing so gives us this next equation. And there you see, if the absolute value of phi is below 1, then this infinite sum can be re-expressed as c divided by 1 minus phi. And that would be the unconditional expectation of an AR1 process that is stationary and not demeaned. So therefore, as a takeaway, keep in mind that the intercept C of an AR1 model is most likely not the unconditional mean of the time series. The more persistent the time series, so the larger the phi, the more different is the unconditional mean of the series from the C.